I work in the realm of atoms and molecules, like this little guy. Now, I don't expect you to know its name or its function, but most people, when they see something that looks like this, know that it represents a molecule. Molecules make up much of our world, so it's easy to take for granted that they exist, much less that we know their structures and behaviors and can harness that information to create the materials that we use in our daily lives. The language that we use to describe molecules is the same language that we use to describe people. The term chemistry itself carries a dual meaning. It's the study of matter, but it also describes the complex emotional and physical interactions between people. Even though, as chemists, we work on the atomic scale with structures we can't readily observe, we can better understand and relate to them through our own actions and experiences. Through the lens of individual experiences, it can seem like we're constantly repeating the same mistakes, that our emotional experiences are no different than those of the people that came before us. But through the lens of science, and particularly quantum chemistry, the greatest aspects of humanity, our innate curiosity, our creativity, and our ability to imagine and explore the unseen are exemplified. The progress we make in understanding chemical systems is seen through the lens of our own actions and experiences and reflects our progress as a species. I have spent roughly half my life thinking about how to turn one yellow liquid into a slightly different yellow liquid. This, at the surface, describes synthetic organic chemistry. Now, it's thanks to the applications of quantum mechanics to chemistry that when I see that liquid's color change, what my mind sees is two molecules interacting and reacting to form something new. Imagine if we could predict the outcome of an interaction, add in all of the variables, preferences, and confounding environmental factors, and determine whether two things are going to bond to form something useful, or whether they're just going to blow up. This is the power of quantum chemistry, a field that applies the principles of quantum mechanics to the study of chemical systems. It allows us to understand how molecules are structured, how they move, and how they interact. To put it another way, it allows us to peer into the invisible world of molecules, uncovering their secrets and harnessing their potential to create the materials, medicines, and technologies that improve our world. Now, our journey into the realm of molecules, it didn't happen overnight. In fact, the process of getting to where we are today is an awe-inspiring demonstration of the power of human creativity, curiosity. Given how comfortable we are with the concept of molecules, it's impressive to think that it was just 200 years ago that the idea that materials are made up of atoms was really just taking hold. 100 years later, with the development of quantum mechanics, we were able to create mathematical linkages that related the structure of molecules or their arrangement of atoms and electrons in space to the observable chemical and physical properties like their color, their reactivity, or my personal favorite, their flammability. This connection provided us with a deeper understanding of molecular behavior and their interactions and allowed us to relate it to their underlying atomic structure. It laid the foundations for the fields of quantum chemistry. With more recent advances in computing, we have further progressed in this field, and we can now not only explain the properties of known molecules, we can predict and design molecules with the properties that we desire. Our ability to mathematically model molecules has made chemical property prediction possible. But it's through our ability to relate to them through our own actions and experiences that we can truly understand the complexity of the molecular realm. Molecules, like people, are dynamic. Picture a stick figure of a person. Now, this only gives you a rough idea of what a person looks like. It's neither detailed nor accurate. The structure of a molecule that I showed you earlier is the same. It's about as accurate a description of a molecule as a stick figure is of a person. Molecules are three-dimensional, and they take on different poses, just like us. For instance, imagine how your body moves and bends and stretches during yoga or a workout. Molecules also move and bend and stretch. And just like us, they don't like to stay in the high energy poses for long. We can detect many of the movements of molecules experimentally, and we have long used this to help elucidate their structures. Through our quantum chemical models, we can predict the movements of molecules and the frequencies associated with them. And while this might seem like a small accomplishment, it has a huge impact on our ability to understand the makeup of the universe. Our models allow us to relate the signals detected by radio telescopes to the individual signals detected by distinct molecules. And through this, we are able to better understand the chemical composition of things like interstellar clouds. Molecules also get excited. Much like Superman, when exposed to the right type of light, molecules gain special abilities. More recent work in our field has studied how molecules interact with light. And through our quantum chemical models, we're understanding what the molecules look like in these excited states and what they can do in these excited states. Through this combined effort, we are able to do what previously only nature was able to do. We can harness light, an abundant natural resource, to create new compounds. Our ability to understand how molecules interact with light is allowing us to create better processes for decontaminating drinking water and create the materials that harness light to make the fuels of the future. Now, the next big challenge we face is in understanding how molecules behave as part of a system. Or to put it another way, how their environment and social interactions affect their behaviors. This is important because while our models might predict that a reaction should be favorable between two molecules in isolation, it can be experimentally inhibited by the other things in the system. This can be related to humans through considering something like bringing about social change. An idea that seems simple or easily achievable in isolation, say as a passing thought, or in conversation with a friend, is much harder to achieve when you account for the amount of support you need from people in order to enact the necessary policy changes or opinion changes. Similarly, we need to account for the support of other molecules in the system in order to correctly predict whether a reaction will occur. And much like understanding human social dynamics, this isn't an easy task. But this becomes critical in fields like the development of medicines, where a major challenge is understanding how a drug molecule will interact with its target, say a protein in the body. There are many interactions between the molecule, its target protein, and the other molecules in the body, like water. And while each of these interactions might only have a small energetic cost associated with it, they can add up to make the interaction of the molecule with its target protein less effective. And a molecule that can't effectively bind to its target isn't a drug. So, if we can account for all of these little energetic changes, we can improve our predictive models and accelerate the rate at which we're developing new medicines. All of this is made possible by our ability to imagine, explore, and extrapolate. We have come not only to understand, but to create in a realm that we cannot see. In just two centuries, we've come from understanding that molecules are made up of atoms to being able to predict how molecules behave and design molecules with the properties that we desire. So the next time you are feeling disheartened by the seeming lack of progress we're making as people, as a society, think about a molecule. And hopefully it reminds you that the greatest aspects of humanity are creativity and our ability to imagine, explore, and extrapolate are constantly allowing us to advance and create things that improve the world for all of humanity.